Steve Dotto here. Thanks for joining us today. Our topic du jour is forms. There are a wide variety of different types of forms that we can use in the online world to gather information. Everything from order forms to opinion forms to registration forms. There's lots of different ways that we want to use forms. And as many different ways as there are, as many different types of forms that there are that many different ways for us to create and manage forms. There's a variety of different tools. So I'm going to take a look today at one tool that I've been using for about 3 years. It's called Email Me Forms, and it's a small software as a service tool that's online that allows me to create forms that are ideal for either embedding in websites or for reaching out to people through email. But you don't necessarily have to purchase software in order to have access to online forms for gathering information. If you have a Google account, one of the real hidden kind of secret gems within Google is, within the Google Google Drive, is this ability here to create forms for free. Now, it's not quite as fancy a tool as the commercial products that we're going to look at a little bit later. It doesn't have quite as many bells and whistles, but it does a great job of creating simple registration forms. And actually, I've done a video on it, which I will link to here. So if you're interested in kind of dipping your toe in the water using and seeing what's available for free, Google Forms is a great place to start. But if you need a little bit more, then you're going to want to be taking a look at one of the other tools. There's tools like SurveyGizmo, and there's this Woofoo, which is probably the most popular of the forms tools. It's the one that I started with. It's not the one that I actually ended up purchasing myself and using. I chose a tool called Email Me Form. Why did I choose that over the others? It really came down to price. It was a little bit less expensive for the same features. And so I started with it 3 years ago, and I've seen no reason to switch. It does all of the things that I want to do. And actually, I have a pretty wide range of needs for using online forms. I have registration forms for different events that I have. I have contest forms that I both embed in my website and I send out in my newsletter. An Email Me Form allows me to do all of my different forms and allows me to distribute them in any way that I want. And that is a key. If you have a website, you then are going to look at a forms tool that where you can embed forms in your website. But most people don't have a website, or if they do have a website, they're not the one managing it and they don't want to wait for the IT department to embed a form in the site. Instead, for a lot of us, it's far more convenient to reach out by email and email out our forms and have people fill out the forms based on an email that they receive. An Email Me Form, as you can imagine from the name, does a really good job of enabling email forms that we can send out. Let's dive into it and take a quick look and show you what you pay for if you're purchasing an email package. Now, this is my account in Email Me Form, and along the top are the basic navigation areas. You can create forms from scratch, but they also have a variety of templates that help you create your forms, and there's a nice WYSIWYG editor for managing your form. So let's take you into the templates to begin with, because that's probably the place that most of you would start if you ended up purchasing a service like this. And you can see here that they've got templates for agriculture, associations, all the way through to travel. There's a variety of different forms. And just by poking around these a little bit, you can get a good idea for what you can do with these forms. For example, if we go in and take a look at the restaurant form, there's a little takeout order form that they have here. Now you can use this as a template. But the reason I wanted to show you this is, look, they've got, I guess this is for pizzas. If you want to order a ham pizza, look, if you can choose two, they do calculations. They have the ability to calculate and do intelligent calculations within the forms. And in fact, the Email Me Form also has hooks so that you can tie it into e-commerce systems such as PayPal or Stripe or some of the other systems. So you've got a lot of upward functionality, not just gathering information, but actually doing e-commerce using these forms. That's probably a little bit of the deep end of the pool for most of us. Most of us kind of want to gather a registration form for people coming to a conference, or we want to sign people up for mail lists or that sort of stuff. That's where we want to use the forms. So let's take a look at some of the other simple forms that they have as well. If we go into the education forms here, we can see that they've got testing, the ability to do testing and create all of those sorts of measurements where we ask people for a range. So it works very well for research, survey type of stuff. In the personal forms area, they've got little trivia quizzes that you can put, and these are great for building community and that sort of stuff. So you've got all of these different types of forms available to you. Let's go back to the restaurant form And let's show you how the editor looks, because let's say that I want to use this form. I click on Customize Template, and that takes me into now the editor, where I can actually go in and modify all of the different features or all of the different aspects and elements within the form. And if we take a look in the add field area, this really kind of gives us the best picture of what we can do with a form. These are the basic types of data that we gather: numbers, names, paragraph text. We can put in checkboxes, etc. Under the advanced area, we can do things like putting in websites and phone numbers. Now, this is to gather that information. This isn't putting in our website. This is gathering information. So if here we wanted to add a website, for allow people to put in their website as they're putting in an order form for pizza. I don't know why you would, but you just drag and drop that, and now see, it's dropped it in as website, and it's already pre-formatted here for you. So you've got all of these different capabilities to be able to add different data types. And down in the bottom, we have survey tools, things like putting in a star rating system where you can add stars. And if you put that in and click on it, you can actually edit the options, saying number 1, 2, 3, 4. You can add more options. You can basically customize it any way you want. So this gives you, I think, I'm hard-pressed to come up with a type of form that this software won't support. Now, once you've built your form, that's just the first step. Then you have to distribute the form and start gathering information. So let me show you how that part works as well. So I'm going to go back into my forms here. I'm going to leave this page. I'm not going to save it. And it's already created it and saved the basic one here as my latest form. But if you look here in the other forms, these are all of the forms that I have. And I have a total of 62 forms that I've done in the last about 3 years, I think I've been using it. So you can see I'm doing about 20 forms a year that I'm doing for different types of projects. But here is one which I'll use to kind of walk you through some of the things I did, because there's no personal information in it. It was just a questionnaire after a webinar that I delivered. So if I want to see the results of all of the people who have responded to this particular one, I just click on the data field, and here I can see all of the different responses that people have done from that particular survey. And I can export. The nice thing is I can export this, and it exports it into a spreadsheet file so that I can sort it and I can work on the data and work in a variety of different ways on the data. Now, I can choose how I want this reported to me as well. What I mean is I can just gather all of the data here in the data field, and then when I come in and visit my account, I can look and see how many people have registered. Or if I go under notifications, I can have it let me know and send an email to any of my email addresses whenever there's a response. I can also ask it to set up an autoresponder, setting up a message that goes back to people as soon as they have completed the form, thanking them for the form or following up with some other area. And here beneath it, you can also start to integrate forms with other autoresponder packages like Aweber, for example. You can set it up for gathering and building your mail list, and you can also send the data directly to another application if you want as well. So you've got some nice flexibility of how you respond when people enter data into the form. One of the most important areas is the code area. If we click here on the code, let me go back to where's my form that I'm working on. There we are. Code. If I click on the code button, this is where we create the embed codes or the links that we send out in email. And so we have the ability to be able to create JavaScript embeds or iframe embeds. So if you have a website, you can actually drop the form right in to your website. Let me show you how that looks. Let me just jump over. This is my speaking page on my website. So this is the Dotto Tech website, which I hope you visited. And if you scroll down here to the very bottom of it, I want to gather, if people are interested in having me speak to them at an event, I want to gather that information. So this is actually an email me form that I've dropped in here as an embed right within my website. Now, you have to be careful to make sure that you're paying attention to how wide the forms are and that sort of stuff versus how wide your pages are on your web page when you create the form, because there can be some little issues here. But this is a great way of adding some extra communication capability to your website through using the forms. Super easy to do. As you can see there, we just have to select the proper form here. Now, there are some other things that we can do with it as well. If we click on HTML link, this here will allow us to take this. If we copy this and just let me go to a new tab here, and this would be a link that you would embed in an email. This is what people would see if they went to this link in the email. There's the form that we just asked, that we were just looking at. So if you create an email, so as opposed to having this embedded in my website now, this, and this is actually hosted by the folks at Email Me Form. As soon as they gather all of the information here, and as soon as the person submits it here by clicking on the submit button at the bottom, then a new record is created in my account in Email Me Form, and we will see that data, and we'll have gathered that data. So it's nice and flexible, both using our website and using email for sending and receiving forms. Some of the other things that I just wanted to quickly touch on before we go too far is they also have payment options here. So if we click here on payment, it's a premium. This one costs you a little bit more. You have to buy the Pro or the Premier plan. So I think it's about $20 a month in order to have the full merchant setup. But here you can set up payment options for being able to collect money if you have an order form or something like that. And it integrates with all of the standard payment systems, including, I'm happy to see, Stripe, which is my current favorite one. And also, you can also set up invoices coming through, and you can integrate it right with things like FreshBooks. So some nice flexibility there. And as if all of that isn't enough, if you're a super advanced type person, you can go in and you can set up logic. This is so cool. When we click on logic, what it does is it looks at the form that we're working on and allows you to set up rules based on that form. So if I go into field rules and I create a field rule, what it does is it looks at the different fields that I have, and it says, if in under the name it contains something, then do something. So if you think about an order form, or if you think about a questionnaire, if people say they didn't like the webinar, then show them these questions. If they say they liked the webinar, then show them these questions. So you don't have to have all of the questions there, but you can actually branch people through depending on their responses using field rules and page rules and form rules, and even into payment rules. If they order something and they have purchased this, then you make sure that you also offer them to purchase this other thing if you're going to do a follow-on sale or something like that. So the more that you use this software, the more that you kind of dive in under the hood, the more capabilities that you will discover. And it's got, as I say, you can see it's a nice, rich application. How much do they cost? Let's just take a quick look here at how much it costs. For this one here, for Email Me Form, $9.95 a month is the basic, but you can try it for free, which will allow you to do a small number of forms and to kind of test things out. The Pro version is $20 a month, and you can get about a 20% discount if you pay upfront for a full year. So that is Email Me Form. Now, the WooForms and some of the others, and some of the others, they're really not all that different in pricing. If we take a look at the WooFoo, it's a little bit more. I think their basic is $14 a month, yes, and then their higher-end systems are $29 a month, and, you know, you kind of get into, it gets a little bit more expensive, and they might have a little bit prettier interface and all that sort of stuff, but, you know, with these tools, it's more the use of them. You figure out how they fit in your life by spending time with them. So I say choose a good one, try the free trial for a little while. Once you kind of have a handle on it, purchase the account and then just run with it. And don't spend too much time worrying about what the other guys have, because for the most part, they all have the same basic features, and it really comes down to your skills as far as using them most effectively. I hope you found this video to be effective and useful of your time. And if you have, please give us a like, and don't forget you should subscribe to our channel. Every week we're going to release another good productivity video just like this one, which I hope you find incredibly valuable. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with me today.